Hey, High Levelers, Rio Daniel here, and I wanted to give you a quick update regarding some new cool features that was recently added to Conversation AI, because I really think these new features could help you in a couple of different ways. And the goal of this video is, number one, show you what these features are, where they're located, but then how to use them. Again, like my typical videos, open up your mind and give you the ability to expand this idea into your business so that you can take these features and turn it into something that could really help you out. So let's hop into it and let's take a look at the new features. Okay, so right now we're hopped into one of our demo companies here. This one is going to be our DigiGlobal marketing agency. So this is, again, like a digital agency. Right now, a couple of things that I want to sit back and show you is inside of your settings. So we're going to go to Conversation AI. Now, first of all, I just want to make sure that you understand they haven't updated the Conversation AI bots yet, where you can have multiple bots listening on one channel. So please keep in mind, this is so important that Highlevel put it in here. Important. Only the primary bot will respond to inbound messages, okay? So please, that's something I've mentioned on previous videos, but that could be something rather frustrating. So you have to make sure that whatever bot you program that you want to get going is set as primary. And you know that by this little tag right here, this is primary, obviously. So anyway, that's my little soapbox thing. So right now what I want to do in this video, I'm not going to go over all the stuff that I've already gone over with AI. I'm not going to tell you all the features. I'm not going to tell you how to program stuff. I just want to show you the cool new features. That's it. And try to make this video as short as possible, but at the same point, give you a demo so you can see how this thing works. So let's hop into this particular bot. We're going to open this up and we're going to be spending our time here on the bot goals. Now here on the bot goals, what I want to do is that there's a couple of different things here. First of all, if you scroll down, notice that we've got these new two additional features now. Trigger a workflow, add contact info. Now, if you've already watched my AI agent, my voice AI agent video from a little while ago, you would have realized that some of these features have already been added into the voice AI agents. They never were added into Conversation AI. Now, again, I want to sit back and know, as of the publishing of this video, voice AI and Conversation AI do not integrate. Meaning, if you program the Conversation AI bot with all the training and all the stuff that I've shown you in my other videos, the voice AI bot cannot use that training database to answer questions on the voice call. I'm sure that's coming. I'm sure they're going to connect it to you, but I want to make sure that you know that these are still not connected. So Conversation AI, voice AI are separate in their sort of training databases. Now, please watch the voice AI if you want more information over that, but you can update and ask for additional information if you program the ChatGPT prompt here on the screen correctly. Now, what I want to do is show you a couple of cool features that you can actually add into Conversation AI that I've seen pop up either on my SaaS Jumpstart community, which is my sort of free course that I give you just a lot of snapshots and a lot of free stuff, and even a 30-day action plan to success for those people who just signed up, step-by-step what to do. So the link is in the description if you want to sign up for that free course. But here, I've seen a lot of people talk about how they can get Conversation AI to do other things, better things, and some of them are what I'm going to be talking about here. I want to start by adding the contact info. Now, one of the things that people have always wanted is, how can we have a chatbot that can gather and populate custom field data? Now, I'm going to talk about using custom fields in the prompt. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about having the bot ask the person on the chat widget information. Maybe it has to be specific, and I'll show you my case that I built here. But asking them for specific information and then recording that information into a custom field for that contact record. So that's what I'm going to show you, how to do that and how to set that up. And what I want to do is show you one way that you can do a call transfer on Conversation AI and actually make a connection with somebody who's actually on the website and they have a question and they might want to talk to somebody. How can you actually make up an actual live call connect of that person into the, from a live person to actually have them call in right away? So that's something that I've seen people ask about either in my community or in the High Level group. So I want to sit back and help you understand these new features and just, again, show you how to implement them and maybe do some cool things in your business. Okay. So right now we're going to go into the contact info. Now for the time's sake, I'm going to go ahead and save some time. I created a custom field called website type. Now this type is going to be WordPress, GoDaddy, Wix, custom, whatever, but it's going to be the type. And that's all we're doing is that if somebody does say that they already have an existing website and it's that type of thing, then the bot or the prompt is going to ask them what type of website they currently have, and then take that information and record it into a custom field called website type. Now I'm just calling this action type website type. You can call it whatever you want. Here inside of the contact field being updated, notice that if you click on here, you do get a list of all the different types of fields. As you see, the website type is one of them, so you can choose the custom field type here. Now, what to update in this field? What type of website the user replies back to with if asked? Now, they're not always going to, the prompt isn't not always going to ask the person this. I'm going to show you what I did to the prompt that's going to do this and then show you the example of how that would work. So I'll give you some examples of this, but then some of the output examples here, I just gave WordPress and GoDaddy for this one and then saved it. So this right here will at least sit back. And now if they're asked what the website type is, that website type will then just be reported into the custom field for that particular contact record. See? Great. So right now, let's go ahead and take a look at the prompt. And if we scroll down a little bit, sorry about that. Let's dive into the prompt here to the scrolling. So I've put this down here at the bottom. Forgive me. I'm going to try to blow this up a little bit. So I put right here, this is my own kind of prompt. I'm going to highlight it just so that, and it just says, if the user asks a question regarding updating their website, just something like that, or something similar, I want you to ask them what type of website they currently have. Example being WordPress, GoDaddy, Wix, or something like that. That's one. Now, the other thing is I'm going to come down here and I'll address the other prompt when we get to a workflow. But right now, that's really it. And what I want to do is come over here and because I'm dealing with the live chat widget here, that's one of my favorites. What I want to do is I want to come over here and load a new incognito window because right now the chat widget keeps track of your visits and stuff like that. But notice we have this here. We're going to come over here and I'm just going to say, let's just say somebody comes, does your company build websites? Maybe they hit it and they're like, hey, does your company build websites? Great. Let's see what they end up saying here. I'm going to move myself over so we can see this a little bit better. Okay. They come back and says, yeah, our company builds websites from scratch. Also update existing ones. We work with platforms like blah, blah, blah. What kind of website do you have? Boom. So right now it's asking what kind of website do they have? Again, it jumped the gun a little bit when it comes to updating websites. But for the purpose of this example, we're going to sit back and just say WordPress. So here, now that you said WordPress, they've responded with what type of website that you currently have. And then from here, now that you said WordPress, great. We can definitely help you with WordPress site. What specific updates are you looking for? And the bot is going to continue to gather some additional information from here. But for right now, the whole point I'm trying to sit back and make is if we come back over here and look, we see the guest visitor here. And if we come down and look into our basic information here, we do see that if we take a look here, the website type did get the word that we put in there. That is now populated because it's already, we answered it on the quiz. So this is just, again, a quick way that you can actually update a custom field. Now, could this have been a little bit smoother? Yeah, but this is just a real quick example that I wanted to show you about how you can actually populate a custom field or even multiple custom fields based upon changing the prompt in a certain situation, asking the user what they're looking for, and then again, mapping that particular custom field inside of the settings, conversation AI, go into the AI bot or whatever bot you're using as primary, go to your bot goals, and then come down here to your add contact field. And again, if you wanted to, you can add a new field, as many fields as you want, and be as creative as you want. Go and change the prompt, do anything that you want to do and gather all the data that you're looking for. But I just want to expand your knowledge, expand your ideas, and show you what conversation AI can now do and how you can map those fields into the user. Now, could we go through and ask for the person's first name, last name, update their information? Of course, to get a complete contact record. But again, for the purposes of this example, I just wanted to show you how you could update a contact record, a custom field in a contact record. Now, what I want to do is show you about triggering a workflow. A lot of times I see a lot of people saying, can AI automatically call somebody or create an outbound call? Or yeah, it can, but it's not always necessarily directly. It does need a little bit of intervention, a little additional step. So what I've done here is in trigger workflow, what I've done is, let's just say you have somebody in the website that, let me just show you what I did here. So we call this contact manager. And right now, what we did is we're using this workflow I call conversation AI call connect. I'll show you what that is. Very easy, simple workflow. But then what triggers this? The user asks to speak to a manager, owner, or supervisor. So if they're on the website chat and they ask for one of those, then what do you do? Then it fires this workflow. The workflow in turn makes a phone call and so forth, and everything is good. Now, let me show you the workflow real quick here before I come back and show you the prompt, because there are a couple of different pieces to this. So right now, if we come over here, I got a lot of workflows in here, so I'm just trying to pull this out. Here's the one that we were looking at, the one that's published. Keep in mind, it does have to be published in order for you to be able to select it from the list. So right now you see there is no trigger. The reason for there's no trigger is because the conversation AI is manually firing the trigger based upon a certain set of conditions. So we don't need to have a trigger here. The conversation AI will trigger it. So all this is just going to simply be a call. This call is going to just simply come back. And right now I've got this call whisper set up, meaning it's going to make a phone call and whoever answers the phone, Highlevel is going to say this, you're getting a call from a website visitor. And then at that point, if you hit a button on there, then it'll connect the call together and actually connect and call that person directly. So Right now, that's all it is. You could do a bunch of other cool things, but again, this is just proof of concept, so I want to show you what I built here. So now what we're going to do is we're going to come back in here back to the conversation AI, because guess what? You probably already have already thought about it. If you're thinking about this, we're dealing with a live chat widget. On the live chat widget, there is no phone number, there is no name, there is no contact record. So of course, if we're going to connect a phone call, then we're going to have to get the person's phone number from them, perhaps even get their name and so forth. But I didn't go that far on this one. I just simply asked them for their phone number because that's the bare minimum required in order for that call connect to actually work. So what I did here is I'm going to come back in here, come back into our bot goals. And then from here, we're going to come down and scroll here to our conversations area. And I'm going to blow this up a little bit. Again, another one, if the user asks to speak to a manager, supervisor, or owner, tell them that they would that you would be happy to connect them, but you will need to get their phone number first. So obviously you'll need to get their phone number. Once you have the phone number, then Highlevel is smart enough to map that phone number to that particular contact record and so forth. So let's go ahead and take a look here. So if we come back and right here, I'm going to come back and close this window and we're going to open up another one here just to start over again. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to sit back and just obviously just go right for the throat here. I would like to speak to your manager, to a manager immediately, like I'm have some authority here. So right now the word manager is going to sit back and trigger the workflow inside of the prompt. It should come back and just say, great, I'd be happy to connect you. Something like that. Do you please provide your phone number? So I'm going to blow this up. I'll get a manager to reach out to you. Could you please provide your phone number? And then from here, you could put in your, actually, let's put in something that works. So this is another phone number that I've got in one of my other demo accounts. So I'm just going to give it that. Now, when that happens, then right now, that phone number has been updated in the account. And then at this particular point, thanks, I'll pass this along. So you'll be contacted soon. Now, that's what the bot said. But really what happened is, if we come down here and take a look at the automation, notice, let's just see here, the contact that we just had was called visitor XINRI, whatever that is. So that is a user that we had go through the workflow. So if we come over here to conversation, pull this workflow up, come here, look at our execution logs. We see that we have guest visitor XINRI, setback, current call, finish status. Now that I show the call connect and go through the example, no, I didn't do that. I just simply wanted to let you know that the conversation AI triggered the workflow based upon what somebody said, the workflow fired, made a call connect feature with a contact that has an existing phone number. Does that make sense? All of that is done, ready to go. So right now, those are just some cool features here, guys. And again, what you do with them is going to be completely up to you and your own business. I hope you take them and do some cool, wonderful things with you, but this is something new that I've seen conversation AI come up with recently. And I'm like, hey, let me create this quick video to show you some of these new features, what you can do, how you can use them. So go use them and make money in Highlevel. I hope you do. And guys, if you found this video useful, if you liked it, hit the like button. Come on, man. I'm trying to make these videos good for you, trying to provide some information, trying to make my YouTube channel grow. So if you've not subscribed, hit the subscribe button. I do appreciate your support. Thank you guys so much for hanging in there with me and have a great day. Bye-bye.